How y'all doing out there? I left Wayne here to come make another video. It is November 1st, 2018. It's just about 4 o'clock in the afternoon on a Thursday. This video is a little bit different than that's been on my channel in recent time. You know, it's pretty much been football, you know, since probably August. But I wanted to make this video today. And I wanted to, the beard growing out again. I don't know if I'll trim it or not. Anyway, I don't know if you want to call it necessarily a true keto diet. Ketogenic is the proper term for it. It's my version. I'm doing it my way, and I'm having success. You know, it's low carb, high protein, high fat. And I started 28th of September. So tomorrow on the 2nd, will be 5 weeks. And I've lost 17 and a half pounds in 5 weeks. That's almost 3.5 pounds a week. Started at 270. This morning I was about 252 and a half. And I am so proud of myself. You know, I lost a bunch of weight end of 2015, and I was over 300. I was like 313, 310 pounds, and that was like November, no, it was like August, I can't remember, sometime in the fall of 2015. And then by the spring of 2016, I was around 240, 235, somewhere in there. And I was that summer, I was training for my half Ironman, and my lowest was 236. And then 2017 rolled around, and I just didn't have the time like I did the previous year to really do anything. And I still did some running and stuff, but, you know, and then moving to West Tennessee, I put on some weight. You know, I put on about, that's roughly, I don't know exactly how much I put on when we moved here, but I know I put on some weight. You know, it was 236, you know, to 270, and I pretty much had been hovering around that for the last, I don't know, 6 to 8 months. Of course, I know at the same time I put on some muscle, you know, because I've been, you know, back in probably, I don't know, March, February, I started, you know, weightlifting again. And I've done running, you know, in between that. But it's, you know, I've tried so many things, you know, since I moved down here, you know, in year and 4 months, whatever it's been, and I've never had success like I did when I lost it all before, you know, even doing the running and all that, but what it boiled down to was my diet. That was the one thing that, you know, I ran, I lifted weights, you know, I even did some biking a little bit, but, you know, I've always been told, and I'm a believer now, that you cannot out-train a bad diet. There is no amount of exercise, there's no amount of cardio, lifting weights, and I probably made a video about this before, but there is nothing you can do to out-train a bad diet. If you do not get your nutrition intact, you are not going to lose weight. It's just not going to happen. Number one, you have to take in less calories than you're burning. So, now that I am on the ketogenic diet, I'm having success. And I'm no nutritionist, I'm no, you know, world renowned, I'm not none of that. I am just trying to follow, you know, the ketogenic diet to the best of my abilities. And it's hard. I mean, you know, like getting off work, you know, I want to go into a gas station and you know, maybe get a snack. And I said, but I said, there just isn't anything in there that you can have because it's all got carbohydrates. You know, you're pretty much limited to, you know, I do like sunflower seeds sometimes. I might do, you know, a few handfuls or pork rinds. That's pretty much it. Because everything else is, or the whole beef jerky, that's not bad. Or the little turkey sausage bites, I get those sometimes. Those only got one carb per serving. There's only 4 servings in a whole bag. And it's about, even, and I think, you know, there's a lot out there, a lot of people that are not doing it. They don't stick to it. They don't have enough faith in the diet in order for it to work. And what I mean by that is, you know, they do it for a couple weeks and they have no success. Or they do it and they lose a little bit of weight and then they hit a plateau and then they just give up. You have to stick to it. Because I had a plateau for about a week and a half. I didn't lose anything. But I stuck to it. And I know why, because I had taken in, I went to the game, I drank some beer and had some wing. I took in a lot of carbs, you know, for over a few days. And then this past weekend, I ate a chocolate bar. So that altered my weight loss success. But now that I am back on the diet, you know, strict to the diet, I'm back to losing. Even when I was, you know, when I had the beer, the car, you know, and the wings and the, you know, the chocolate bar, I didn't gain. But you have to stick to it. You have to be strict to it. You have to have faith in the diet. You know, the low carbs, the high fat, the high protein. And you need to exercise. You know, I think that's a vital key in any diet, is to have at least 3 to 4 days a week. You know, 2 to 3, at least 2 to 3, but 3 to 4 is better. Because you got to burn off those extra calories. And that's the problem, I think. So many people, they're watching the carbs, but they're not watching the overall calorie intake. And that's one of the biggest things when it comes to losing weight, is how many calories are you taking in? You know, you still have to watch that. And I think that's where a lot of people fail on this diet, is there, you know, there's so many things you have to take into consideration, and they're not doing that. Carbs is one thing, but you also have to watch the calories. So, I just want to make this video, you know, update you on how I'm doing. It's not been easy. I mean, it's been hard, and the problem is it's a little more expensive because, you know, you're not eating all the crap. You know, you have to buy real food. It's not for everybody, but, you know, I'm having some success with it. You know, if you get a chance, check it out. You know, maybe you've tried everything, you know, and you just can't seem to find the answers you're looking for, the success that you're looking for. Check out the ketogenic diet. There's so many companies out there that have meal plans, you know, but I'm doing it without that. I mean, or you can go on and get recipes for free on all these different websites. You know, it comes down to, how bad do you want it? That's what it boils down to. And you've got to want it. That's it. And you've got to work at it. You've got to be strict. It's the only way it's going to happen. But you'll thank yourself later. I feel better. I feel better about myself and losing the weight. Obviously, I've got a long way to go. I'd like to get down to 220 or so, and then start putting muscle on after that. You know, I'd like to bulk up a little bit, but, you know, we'll take it one step at a time. That's kind of the video. That's kind of what I wanted to say. We got the Charlotte game this weekend. I just uploaded. I shot the video on Tuesday and I completely forgot to upload it. It should be up anytime now. The Tennessee South Carolina review. Check that video out. Well, I'll have the reviews probably Monday, Tuesday. I don't know exactly when. I will try to get it up on time this week. And then, you know, after that, we've got, I think, Kentucky, and then Missouri, and then Vanderbilt. Pinnacle games coming up. Got to win this Saturday, and then we got to Kentucky. I don't think we're good enough to beat Kentucky. I think we can beat Vanderbilt, Missouri. You know, Missouri's winless in the SEC. Vanderbilt's only won one game, but you know, we'll see as the season goes on, and we'll see where we stand after the Charlotte game. You know, nothing's guaranteed in college football. So anyway, appreciate y'all watching. Be like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.